I'm Mojiza Mimi Mojo, and I keep getting a lot of requests from everyone to talk about my art journey, how I began, how I started finding inspiration, and what are the supplies that I use for creating art. So I've been an artist for the last 3-4 years now, not very long, and I haven't had any formal education, obviously. But this is all self-taught, and from my experience, I can tell you what works, what doesn't. So let's get started. I'm going to take you through the supplies that you need, first of all. Obviously, if this is for oil paintings, I will be doing sessions for acrylics and watercolors later on. But the first thing that you need to get sorted is your canvas. So I picked up an entire canvas pad from Venus Traders, which has a lot of around 26 sheets, which are pretty large in size, around 2 feet by 4 feet size, and it's a decent price. So you can check out Venus Traders in Pune. You can also get stuff like this from Amazon, which is boards of canvas which are smaller in size or even larger in size that you can paint as you like. And people do like small canvases nowadays. I've seen it picking up. So that's the next series I'll be doing. You can also use anything that will hold oil, like wood, or I wouldn't recommend glass, but you can use oils on any kind of paper or cloth textured canvases, so that works as well. But the best thing is to just pick up a canvas pad. Nowadays everything is ready made. You don't have to actually make the canvas yourself. You don't have to stretch it out. They used to do that manually years ago, but now everything is ready made. It's pretty easy to get. You can get it on Amazon, you can get it on Etsy. So I'll leave the products that you need here. The second thing you need, obviously, is paint brushes. So there's a lot of variety of paint brushes. I would say the three basic things you need to look at is the hair on the brush. So as you can see, this one is a hog hair brush. It's pretty stiff. So any stroke that I make with this is going to leave a mark on the canvas. It's going to be visibly a paint brush mark. If you want to look for a softer brush, you can again head to Venus. They have some finer horse hair or even artificial synthetic hair brushes, which are much easier to use for blending purposes. So if you need something which is smooth, you can go for this. Even fine art has good quality brushes. So they have soft hair and thick hair as well. So you can choose depending on the kind of stroke you want in your painting. Other than brushes, which are of that size, obviously sizing is the next factor. So as you can see, I have this convenient brush holder which came from Amazon as well, a gift from my friend who actually got me started on art. This helps you to kind of store all your brushes properly. You can see I have some really fine ones, I have some medium sized ones, and I have 0.0 ones, which are very good for detailing. So now it's not necessary that you have a separate set of brushes for oil or for acrylic, but I like to keep mine separate because acrylics tend to dry quickly, and if you forget to clean it, your brush is gone, you'll have to discard it. Oils are cleaned faster with spirit, but you have to take care of them obviously because the hair will start eroding over time. So storing your brushes carefully, cleaning them and taking care of them is a challenge, especially with oil paints. In brushes, you can also look at ready-made sets which are available on Amazon. You can look at brushes by some of the master companies like Winsor & Newton or Sennelier, but let's come to that later once you are at a professional stage. Initially, you can just start off with the basic supply of paint brushes. So the next thing you need is paint. I am currently using the entire Winsor & Newton set of oil paints, which have amazing pigmentation, which have really bright colors. If you can see that painting up there, I did that with this color scheme, and they have very good rich texture, but they are expensive, obviously, because they are the brand. The next, obviously, the other most expensive brand is Sennelier. I think I have just one black pigment in that, but it is a very fine paint. It is very rich and again expensive. So if you don't want to spend so much right now, since you're just starting off, you can use something like Camlin, which has artist grade colors. Don't go for the student grade, but start off with the artist grade colors, easily available on Amazon and again places like Venus. If you are in some other part of the country, you can check out your local stores as well. So that's pretty much it for the three basic things. Now the next thing that you need is obviously a palette. Now this is my palette, it's a mess. So you can see it's a wooden board which I've wrapped in cellophane paper, cling wrap, because I don't like to keep cleaning my board again and again. It's a big mess. Got paint again. It's a big mess to clean oils. It gets your hands dirty. It gets your house dirty. So I just throw away this covering every time after using it. But the best alternative is to use, as a beginner, you can start off with paper plates. You can use multiple paper plates for different pigments and mix it directly on the plates. Or else, if you have a nice big glass table, that is the best for blending colors. So I will do a course separately on how to blend colors, but let's stick for the basics right now. Other than palettes, you will also need your basic drawing instruments like pencils, if you want to start with a sketch. So I'll tell you how I started. I saw Bob Ross and I was really inspired. My friend actually bought me all the supplies and I started watching Bob Ross videos. Landscapes are my main. I love drawing landscapes. I love focusing on details, textures, and the color blends in all these landscapes and trying to make it as realistic as possible. But I'm still learning, obviously. So you can definitely start off by researching what inspires you. See what you want to make. Study different types of art. Talk to people who've gotten into art as a career, if you're really looking at it seriously. And just start. Just don't worry too much about getting things right. It took me a long time to get to the stage that I am right now, and I still have a long way to go. So don't worry about getting things wrong or getting, you know, your art famous. Just try to create quality content and just begin. So now let's come to finishing and oil painting. So these are the materials you need for starting. For finishing, once you're done with an oil painting, it takes at least up to 6 months to dry entirely, after which you can apply something called the picture varnish. This will help your painting last longer, prevent it from getting cat fur stuck on it like mine does, and prevent dust from settling on it, extend the longevity of the painting. Well, that's a long-term process. You can even have paintings retouched later on if you start a professional studio. You can have your clients come back to retouch their paintings, because oils tend to change over time. The pigments become different, the colors become different. The whole look of it goes away if you don't take care of it. I prefer not to frame my oil paintings in glass. I like to keep them open. So as you can see, I use boards like these, which have the edge or a thick board. Or else I use my normal canvas sheets and I get those sheets onto a board, or I get them framed, just the outer frame directly. So it looks good, but it's difficult to maintain it over a long time. So you can decide how you want to present it to the client. They will have their own choices to make anyway. So I don't think there's much else that you need other than something to dilute your paints when you're painting. So obviously, to clean your brushes, you're going to need spirit. This is the one I like. It is from a local hardware store. It's called a reducer or a thinner, and it's only for paints. Don't get any into your eyes or your mouth or anywhere dangerous, because it's a chemical, obviously. And wash your hands well. Use gloves while brushing, cleaning your brushes. So what I like to do is dip my brush in a cup full of the thinner and then just rub it like that. So it takes off the spirit, and then I dab it into a tissue paper and it takes off the color and the spirit, and then I can use the same brush for another color. Obviously, if you're starting with a white paint, never use a brush which is already used, because there will be some pigment left over and it will affect your white. If you want a pure white, have an entirely new brush. You can use something which is, okay, this doesn't look that great, but this is linseed oil, which helps you to thin down your paint, which helps you to make it easier to flow when you're painting it. You can also use smaller bottles of spirit similar to your thinner. Linseed oil is richer than spirit, so it makes the texture better, the colors better without diluting the paint. But thinner will actually thin down the paint, make the colors less strong. So you'll see a brown becomes skin toned if you add too much of thinner. So it can be a problem to control the amount of thinner you're using. I generally take a thick brush and I just dab a little bit of thinner onto my paint and then I blend it out. So like I mentioned, I will be teaching blending techniques, and you guys can let me know what else you want to learn. So the other thing I wanted to talk about is when it comes to oil paints, it is difficult to control the pigmentation when you start off, because as a learner you will apply a layer of paint and then you'll want to apply something on top of it. But if you don't apply it properly, it's going to take off the initial layer. Okay, so you don't have to use too much pressure. I think I'll have to do a separate session on the types of pressures and the types of painting techniques. But for now, let's focus on getting your art supplies in place. And you guys can either use an easel. So I do have an easel which is pretty large, which is extendable, which I got as a gift again from a friend. But you can get the same thing on Amazon. There's a set of easels which come with ready-made boards, four different sizes of boards, and there's paint always on my hands. So you can get that, or else you can start with a basic canvas sheet which is stuck onto something hard, so it's easy for you to paint. You can even use one of the suitables which rise up, and you stick the canvas onto the suitable and then you can paint it. Later on you can obviously peel off the tape, so you'll have a nice straight border on the edge of your painting. If you don't want a border, then stick the tape on the back of the canvas, so it's easier to paint all over it. Be prepared to get your house dirty, your room dirty, your hands dirty, and try to have a separate place for painting, because oil is messy, but it's fun. It's real fun. So I hope this helps all of you. Thanks.